discover that you feel that. Somebody shout on your world, I dare you to look down at your feet. Why? Because there's triumph in their hand. Triumph in their hand. It's about me in you. Because you now must become deliverers. You see? You become what? Deliverers. God's put in your hands the power to deliver. Where you are, what you're doing is no accident. God has you for such a time as this as a deliverer. So don't you get discouraged by nothing. Work with that. Work with it. Because God's going to work his will and good pleasure through you. You're the conduit that he's going to use. He's trusting you with it. Look at this. The seed of dinner began with parsley and lettuce dipped in salt water. The green vegetable symbolizes springtime, the time of the year when Passover falls. Salt water recalls the tears that the Jews shed while in slavery. Side by side on the cedar plate, a roasted lamb, bone, and egg, reminding Jews of the sacrifice that they made to God. A dish of bitter herbs serves to remind Jews of the bitterness of slavery. Also on the cedar table, a mixture of grated nuts, apples, cinnamon, and wine, symbolizing the mortar for the bricks Jews had to make while they were Pharaoh's slaves. Near the cedar plate are three pieces of matzah, representing the cracker-like bread the Jews ate while fleeing the Egyptians across the desert. During that cedar dinner, family members read the Haggadah, the book which explains the Passover holiday. Look at this now. Deuteronomy 2, question out loud. Who is God to you?
Who is God to you?
God to many of us are many different things. You've heard it before. He's bread when you're hungry. He's water when you're thirsty. He's company when you're lonely. He's your medicine when you're sick. He can become whatever we need. Somebody shout everything.
Amen.
And when the son asked thee in time to come, saying, what meaneth the testimonies and the statute of this judgment, which the Lord our God hath commanded you, then thou shalt say unto thy son, we were Pharaoh's bondsmen in Egypt, and the Lord brought us out of Egypt with a mighty hand. And the Lord showed signs and wonders, great and sore, upon the Egyptians and upon Pharaoh and upon all his household before our eyes. Look at here. And he brought us out from this that he might bring us in to give us the land which he sware by our fathers. And the Lord commanded us to do all these statutes, to fear the Lord our God for our good always, that he might preserve us alive, as it is this day, and it shall be to our righteousness if we observe to do these things, these commandments before the Lord our God, as he had commanded us. If I may drop this little nugget for son Joseph, he was so excited today. I won't tell you the business, but just it's a testimony. He's been applying for a job. And he applied in a place where there were a multiplicity of people. He said, too many folks. Because they were just looking at him. Nobody got a personal interview. They were just checking out and asking him questions. He said, it was too many of the other persuasions. There was no way he was going to be able to do this. And it didn't happen. Went for the interview. They never called him back. He went for another. Never called him back. Said, the Spirit of the Lord told him today, son, do it right. Do it the right way. Pray first. He said, then I little got on my knees and I said, God, I'm going today for a job. I just want your will in this. In Jesus' name. He went in there. Same thing. Everybody that was there, could be there, was there. He said, I don't stand a chance. But what he don't know, he had turned on the enabler. That will make people see what you don't know.
That's
right. Oh, you hear what I'm saying? And he went at 3 o'clock. And everybody got looked at and said, was your name, what your name is, your application? She said, well, won't nobody know until 12 o'clock tomorrow whether we want you or not. Interviews at 3 o'clock. He gets home at 4:30. The phone rang. Said, you Justin Williams? We want you. You got the job. He was moved by it. He was trying to find it. Hey, that can tell somebody. And what you don't know, that's what God wanted them to do. When God opens doors and makes the way for you, that's how the remembrance of God stays alive. In your body, but you ain't gonna shut up.
You better know.
You're gonna go down the history and say, that's that boy who got $10 million. And what you gonna do, try to get in line. Because you're saying, if God can do it for this man, he'll do it for that woman, he'll do it for you. Slaves, Not machines, man. People who literally died trying to make it. Wherever they would fall, dead ends with pitch to the side. And some were buried in the pyramids. God had to leave a sign. Everywhere he brought deliverance to his people, even across the sea. Here it is, God, he got me right there. Even in the Red Sea, although it's cut now, there's stones in the Red Sea. Didn't the scripture say the rocks protect? If the rocks could speak, if the rocks that's buried in the Red Sea could talk, they would tell you this is where. This is the trail that the children of Israel took when the Lord delivered them on dry ground. Are you seeing it?
Priesthood, a holy nation unto him.